I hope you don't mind. I'm becoming a professional already in this job of bear with me. I was asked by National Scientist Helia Castillo to beam her message. She really wanted to be here, but because of the long trip, coming here from Philippines is almost 24 hours, including the waiting time. She couldn't stand long trips, so she did ask me to read her message. It's going to be very short. Science must serve a human purpose. It's a precept I've tried to live by. I've always believed that when the best science and scientists are devoted to the problems of those who have less in life, that is equity and ethics at its best. If science is to serve a human purpose, what better human purpose is there? In agriculture and in health research, I found fulfillment of this precept in philosophy and in practice. At the heart of many global initiatives almost 25 years ago was the Commission on Health Research for Development, which was composed of a dozen individuals who, aided by a superb secretariat, addressed the subject of health research, essential link to equity in development. Since everyone was someone and no one was above anyone, the judgments embodied in the report were the collective responsibility of the Commission. For me, the world came together in the Commission. It was fun, in a manner of speaking, for there was a deeply held common goal, characterized by greatness of spirit, inclusiveness, seriousness of purpose, and most of all, a time-limited existence. The definition of health research went beyond the borders of the biomedical into epidemiology, behavioral components, health systems, and health policy. An enlarged research vocabulary, because these are the facts of life in the real world. The Commission's work was characterized by an ethic of caring for those who need care the most. Science was its tool, but caring was its driving force. A quick look at the Forum 2012 report tells me that the famous 1090 gap is less relevant now, and the dominant theme is beyond aid. But creating and strengthening capacity is a continuing great challenge. Quite often, it is easier to build capacity than it is to effectively utilize and maintain productive research capacity. It is a tribute to the global health research community that the 1090 gap is now on its way to becoming less relevant, and beyond aid has emerged as the new mantra. In the meantime, let us not forget those who have not yet reached BRICS status and who desperately need aid during these trying times. As Bill Gates urged his lecture entitled The Impatient Optimist, in the fight to eradicate polio in the last three countries, let's do this together. Together is the operative expression for global. My best wishes to the global health research community and, of special mention here, special greetings to Adolfo Martinez Palomo.